Do you want to make windows that look real, glasses with tiny scratches? Well, look no further. In this video tutorial, we're going to explore how to create convincing glass using OpenPBR inside Maya. Hi creators, welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica and I am your guide through glass. In this video tutorial, we're going to be covering how to make realistic glass because glass can be a little bit tricky. It relies on the right balance of transparency, refraction, reflections, and surface detail. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out your creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in fine-tuning the PBR glass material to make glass feel alive in your scene. All right, so here is the scene that we are going to be using. And by the way, you can download this at academicphoenixplus.com. You can download the scene for free and follow along. What we're seeing here is a thin plane. This is a plane as well, but has a little bit of thickness. We have a glass, and then we have a Buddha with really crazy mesh, but it does have a lot of thickness to it. So what we're going to do is go ahead and select these and assign a new material. Then we're going to go to Open PBR Surface. And this is what it looks like so far. Now, if your object doesn't look like this, let's say the texture is missing and the dome isn't there, it's really important to make sure that you set your project before you open up your file. So to do that, you want to go to File, Set Project, set it to the Happy Buddha in Glass, and then when you reopen it, you go to File, Open, and reopen the Maya file. Everything should be connected and should look exactly like this. All right, so we have this one. I'm going to just call this Glass 1 for now. And right now we have our base color, then we have our specular, and of course the magic happens is with the transmission. So let's go ahead and crank this to 1 and see the magic happen. And we're done. Just kidding. As you can see that the glass is working, but you can also tell that it's a little bit foggy. It almost looks like frosted glass, and that's because of the roughness. So when we go back to our glass shader, the transmission is affected by the specularity. So over here in roughness, we can reduce this to very little or even all the way down to 0. And when you hit play, we now have a much clearer glass. Another part about specularity that gets affected is the index of refraction. And it's really interesting when we look at it through something that has thickness to it. So for example, the Buddha, or the most obvious one, is in fact a sphere. So I'm going to add a sphere here just so you guys compare and assign an existing material and give it some space. You can kind of see everything. So you'll notice that the index of refraction here, wherein the light comes in, hits the object, you can see that we have a reversed image. That's the refraction. That means that light is bending through it. So renderer is assuming that this is a solid piece. What that means is that it is not a fragile piece of glass that's just like a bubble, for example. This is in fact a thick piece of glass. And when we go back to the glass shader and play around with the index of refraction, so I'm going to grab this and just make a selection, hit play, you're going to see as I play around with it, the refraction starts to change, right? And that is basically the reflections around the edges as well as how the light goes through it. And if you go to 1, it disappears. So this represents all different types of fluids. So for example, if you're using water, 1.5 and 1.4 index of refraction is the correct value. Every fluid, every glass has a different index of refraction, so you might want to check it out. You can actually just look it up, index of refractions, and they'll tell you, oh, honey is this one, and you know, water is this, and anyway, it's really neat. So that's how you can control index of refraction. Now, what if you wanted to make the shader feel like it was a thin bubble, for example? I'm going to duplicate this one. Control D, lift it up. I'm going to assign a new material. I'm going to use another open PBR. I'm going to do the same thing, reduce the roughness, increase the transmission. And this time I'm going to scroll down to geometry and click on thin wall. So when I hit render, you can see that the refraction is no longer bending. It's actually straight. So it's more like a bubble. It now sees it as something very thin, and versus down here is like a solid piece of glass. Or you could actually use this for water. So these are the two examples of the difference between thin walled and index of refraction. Okay, so what about the rest of it? What about color? So let's just change the color really quickly to this teal blue. And just like that, you get a type of blue glass. Now be aware that the lighter the color, the better, because as you start getting darker, it's gonna look more solid. So just be aware that sometimes you have to go really light to be able to see through the object. It doesn't have to be just glass, it can also be plastic and things like that. Depth. So I'm gonna go back to white, and in the depth, this one's actually really fun. So if I click on depth and I change it to one, you're gonna see that there's not much of a difference because depth and scatter work together. So if you click on this and then pick on the color pink and let it render, the big difference is in the object that has thickness. So the other ones, you can't see too much of a difference except for the glass, just a little bit. But this one, you can see that the areas that the glass is thinner, you can see through it more, and the areas that are thicker, you can see there's actually color on the inside. So it's a really fun thing because what you can do is reduce the depth or even increase the depth by typing it in. You can get this really beautiful effect. Now, why would you use something like that? Well, maybe the glass has a little bit of tint in it. Another one could be that you're trying to create ocean water and you want it to be light at the top, and as it gets deeper and deeper, it gets its particular color. This is a great way of achieving that look. Another way you can do this is by creating a marble. It's a really fun effect where it uses texture to create a marble. So for example, here's my sphere. I'm going to focus on it. I'm just going to be using the OpenPBR surface. I'm going to reduce the roughness to zero, increase my transmission. Then I'm going to hop into the hypershade. So here's my hypershade. I am going to graph the network here. Here it is. This is going to be my marble. Then I'm going to do an AI image. Then I'm going to go into my folders and find this marble texture. Then I'm going to type in UV projector, which is an AI UV projection. I'm going to select the projection, middle mouse and drag this one to the projection color and change this to spherical. Then I'm going to grab the out color and connect it. And let me zoom in so you guys can see a little bit more. Let me zoom in. Okay. And then I'm going to grab the out color and put it in the transmission color and transmission scatter. I'm going to select this and change my depth to about one. And you can see that it looks a little funny. So you can go back into the projection and say object. And there you go. So the nice thing about this is that I can select the marble and then play around with the depth. So for example, maybe I want it to be more like 1.5. And I also go back in here. I created a different one, like this one. And you can see that it looks like marble. Right? So I guess I'll keep this one here on the side. It's a fun video tutorial, and I'll leave the link in the description so you guys can follow that. It's pretty fun. Okay, let's focus on these guys. Well, let's say that we want to create something that looks like it's cracked, for example. So this is going to mean that we're going to add a texture to it. Since we're going to start involving textures, then that means that we need to start UV mapping. So I'm going to go to UVs, planar mapping options, and I'm going to choose the Z, project, and then I'm also going to grab this one. I'm going to go to object mode and click on the letter G, which is last command. And now they're UV mapped. So I'm going to assign a new material. I'm going to again grab my OpenPBR, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to reduce the roughness, and then I am going to increase this transmission. And then when you want to create a scratch, it's literally a bump map, right? Because it's actually an indentation in glass in real life. So what we're going to do is scroll down to geometry, click on bump mapping, click on the little checker, go to file. This is a black and white image, so I'm choosing bump, click on this little connection. Let's go to the folder, and I have a scratch texture here. You can already see it on the preview. And then don't forget to change this to raw, and the color balance should automatically have a luminance. And there you go. So very quickly, we can create this really interesting looking scratch texture. Now again, you guys can go in and reduce the roughness even further. And because this is thin, then you can actually go in and say this is thin walled. This is what it looks like. Pretty fun. I'm going to try to rotate the camera. Now, one last thing, what if you wanted to add fingerprints on it, right? So sometimes it's not a scratch, sometimes there's a fingerprint on it. I want to show you one last one. I'm going to use this one. I'm going to assign a new material. We're going to use an OpenPBR. I'm going to call this handprint glass. So this one's going to have very little roughness. The transmission's going to go up. Now this is a NURB surface. So if you want to UV map it, we do need to convert it. So let's go to Modify, Convert, NURBS to Polygon Options, and make sure Control Points is active. Doesn't look very good, but that's okay. Press 3. I'm going to nudge this down a little bit so I can hide this original one. Okay, and then nudge this one back up. Let's go to, and I press the number 3. Otherwise, it looks really polygon. So let's press number 3, UVs, Silicon Map. Again, this is a really rough UV that I'm doing right now. And let's close it. And what we're going to do is attach it to the specular color. Go click on the checker, click on File. Let's go to the folder. And we are going to choose the handprint. Don't forget to change this to raw. And then don't forget to make sure, let me collapse all this because it's a little busy. Alpha is luminance under color balance. Let's take a look. And the best way to see it is in an angle. So you can see the fingerprints on the object. These are the subtleties that you want in your glass, for example. It might be a little bit more noticeable if I put it on a regular plane. So let me go ahead and show you guys what that looks like. And there it is. You can kind of see that handprint, right? When you look at it directly, you don't see it. But when it's around in the side, you can see it, right? So basically, if it was glass, you want it to be reflective. But the areas where there is a smudge, like a fingerprint, you want it to be dark. So that's the effect. Now, of course, mine is like black and white, so it's really obvious. But it's a really fun addition to do these things when you're adding glass or even metal into your object. All right, so that is how you guys can create glass. Let me know what you think by leaving a comment below. Did you find this helpful? Anything else you want to take a look at when it comes to OpenPBR and Arnold rendering? Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That's your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Don't forget to go to academicphoenixplus.com where you can download this for free. You can also take a look at my e-courses, which are deep dives into Maya modeling, texturing, and so much more. Please share my videos. If you know of a 3D artist out there that is trying to learn how to create some realistic glass, then please share my videos. That would be amazing. And it also helped me out a great deal. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you in the next video tutorial.